Welcome back, everybody. I hope you've had a pleasant Saturday. Let's go ahead and take a look at the highs we've observed today. 39 in Glasgow, 40 for our friends in Jordan, 34 in Lewistown, 35 in Havre and Great Falls, and 34 up in Cutbank. Now, our almanac for today in Great Falls, 44 is our average high, 24 is our average low. Nowhere near those records we set in 1999 with 71, negative 16 in 1955. For Helena, much of the same for you, average 44 for the high, low 23. And again, nowhere near those records. If we take a look outside right now, currently we're at 30 in Glasgow, 29 in Lewistown, 30 for our friends in Havre, 29 in Great Falls, and 29 up in Cutbank. So a bit of a chilly evening. And with that, we've got some sustained winds, mainly in the teens for the most part, a little bit more breezy along the Rocky Mountain front, 20 up in Cutbank. And that is going to create some wind chills. We'll look at those in just a second. But first, our peak wind gusts today were up there. 37 in Jordan, 40 in Glasgow, 36 in Lewistown, 43 here in Great Falls, and 46 up in Cutbank. I think they topped the charts once again today. Now, our wind chill, it feels like with that wind out there right now, 18 in Lewistown, 20 in Havre, 17 in Great Falls and in Cutbank, and 18 up in Glasgow. So factor in that wind, it actually feels a lot colder than it actually is out there. Now, taking a look at our radar again, a lot of these snow showers are staying west of the divide, and most of them are in the upper elevations. We do have a few around Great Falls, but for the most part, clearing skies for much of the area. That goes for the northeastern part of the state as well, a few clouds near Glasgow. Nothing too significant to worry about. We do have this high wind warning for Fergus and Judith Basin counties. That's going to expire here at 6 p.m. Some gusty winds up to 60 miles per hour, but that will be expiring here within the next few minutes, and a lake wind advisory for our friends over near Fort Peck in Valley and Phillips County. So what are we going to be expecting in the future? Well, a warming trend. Now, this front is actually going to turn into a stationary front. We could see a few disturbances along this front as we head throughout the period. Also, as we look west of the divide, a few snow showers possible, mainly in higher elevations. Those really aren't going to affect the plains, but like I said, near this front, along the high line to Havre, near Glasgow and the Canadian border, we could see a few disturbances, but that is going to recede, and high pressure is actually going to take over for a good chunk of next week, which will be nice. Wind gust tracker, 10 to 20, a few 30 mile per hour gusts here and there. Those are going to calm down as we head towards midnight, but going into Sunday and late Sunday, we could see some 30 to 40 mile per hour gusts for some of the areas. Lows tonight, teens for the most part, 16 in Jordan, 17 in Havre, 22 here in Great Falls, and our highs tomorrow into the low to mid 40s, so looking a lot nicer. Now, looking at our 7-day forecast, Great Falls, not too bad, pretty dry for the most part. 50s as we head towards midweek. We will see a cooling trend by the end of next week. Same for Helena, 50s, so that'll help melt some of that snow. Lows mainly in the 30s. Can't rule out an isolated shower or a snow shower on Thursday, and then cooling off again by the end of next week into the 30s.